What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about dual boot Windows 11 and Windows 10. So let's get right into it. All right, so today is all about installing two operating systems into one machine. I'm doing everything within a virtual machine, but you are able to do it into a physical machine. I just didn't have an available machine to do this. So off the bat, my virtual machine is running Windows 11. So this is the primary operating system, and I want to install Windows 10 so I could switch back and forth. So this is how I did it. So I'm going to right click on the start menu. I am going to go into the disk manager. The reason why I'm going into the disk manager is because I need to create a partition to install Windows 10. Now, this virtual machine, the C drive is 200 gigs. So I want to split it or shrink it down and give my Windows 10 100 gigs so I'm able to install the operating system successfully. So what I'm going to do is right click on the C drive. I'm going to do shrink volume. It's going to do its thing. Eventually, it's going to give me the following. And I am going to type in 100 gigs and megabytes. Boom. And then click on shrink. And that's it. It gave me 100 gigs unallocated. Awesome. Now, because I'm running everything within a virtual machine, I am going to mount the Windows 10 ISO image into the virtual machine. And it's going to give me the autoplay. Now, if I open up File Explorer, there goes the D drive. It is mounted. Now, if you are doing this on a physical machine, you have to take your Windows 10 ISO image and burn it into a flash drive and then shut down your machine. Now, I shut down my virtual machine. Now, for a physical machine, you shut it down, you insert the USB into your physical machine, and you restart your machine, and you either, depending on what machine you have, like Dell or Lenovo, you either press F1 or F2 or F12 to boot into the flash drive. Now, within a virtual machine, I'm able to right click on the tab and then go into power and then power on to firmware, which is going to take me into the boot manager. Now, on a physical world, most likely, if you get into the boot manager, your flash drive should be there and you're going to select it. Now, within my virtual environment, I am going to select CD-ROM. And I'm going to hit enter, and it's going to say, press any key to boot from CD or DVD. I pressed any key. The Windows logo is going to show up. Give it some time, and it should give you this. Awesome. So from here, we're going to click on next. We're going to click on install now. Pick your flavor. I am going to do a Windows 10 Enterprise, and I'm going to click next here. Accept the license and terms. Click next. I am going to choose custom install Windows only, and it's going to take me here. Now we're going to select our unallocated space, which was that 100 gig that we created. We're going to click on next. It's going to start copying the files. Eventually, it's going to get ready and the installation should start. Keep in mind that during the installation of any operating system, it's going to constantly reboot. Now, because you already have Windows 11 already installed into this machine, when it reboots, you're going to get this. This is new. So you have to choose which operating system. Do not choose Windows 11. It's already installed. Windows 10 needs to continue to finish installing onto that partition that we created together. So click on Windows 10, and it's going to start getting ready. Now, eventually, it's going to reboot a couple of times, and it's going to take you back here. The cool thing is that because Windows 10 is considered the default one, if you walk away to get a cup of coffee, it gives you 30 seconds to choose something. If not, it is going to continue the installation, which was Windows 10. I was present, so I selected Windows 10. It gave me just a moment. Eventually, it gives me this. I selected United States. I clicked on next. My keyboard layout was US, so I clicked on yes. I skipped the second keyboard layout, so clicked on skip. I did not give my virtual machine internet access because I wanted to bypass the whole process of signing into a Microsoft account and all that stuff. So it gave me this. So I selected I don't have internet. I clicked on continue with limited setup. And I gave my computer a first username. So I gave it BTNHD and I clicked on next. Now, you are able to create a password, but from my experience, if you give it a password, it's going to ask you three questions that you have to give it answers for recovery. a quick way to get this up and running is just click on next and leave it blank. And once you're inside the desktop, just do a control alt delete and then change the password and then you're good to go. So from here, I left it blank. I clicked on next. Privacy settings, I typically just slide everything to the left to no, then click on accept. For setting up Cortana, I say not now. You're going to get this. We're getting everything ready for you. And eventually it's going to load directly into the desktop, which is awesome. From here, I'm going to right click on the start menu. And within the start menu, I am going to click on run. I'm going to type in msconfig, one word, click OK. And then we are going to go into the boot tab. Now, here in the boot tab, you're going to see automatically the current operating system is Windows 10. The reason why I'm showing you this, guys, because as soon as you shut down your machine and you start it up and you walk away, you're going to come back and it's going to be Windows 10. So you got to pay attention to that window to choose which operating system you want to boot into. You got 30 seconds. If you want it to boot into Windows 11 automatically, just select Windows 11. And then from here, just pick set as default, apply it, okay, and then you should be good to go. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.